Hi, I'm Dr. Sulata Shenoy, Director, Turning Point, Center for Psychological Assessments, Therapies and Counseling, Jayanagar, Bengaluru. Losing a loved one is never easy. We have all gone through the relationship when it is over or severe, but physically losing one, not only emotionally, can be very devastating, especially if the person you have lost is your own child. How can you cope with that? Is it even possible for one to overcome such deep grief feelings? And what can a person who sees someone suffer like this can do? First of all, one needs to express heartfelt condolences, not just lip sympathy. And secondly, it is important to know what the other person is feeling, thinking, and needing, rather than projecting your own assumptions about the relationship or about the person onto the bereaved family. So it is not very easy, and many people shy away from it. As a result, they don't know how to convey their condolences, cannot help the person, and become as helpless as the person who is actually in loss. So if you are really intent on helping someone who has been through this extreme loss and you would really like to reach out to him or her, there are a few things you have to keep in mind. One is, be very sensitive about the situation. I have seen people who inadvertently, say something like, maybe it's all for the good, or maybe this was meant to happen, so don't grieve so much, or, she's right now in heaven and she's fine and there is nothing to worry and you should get over it, as if grieving is a sign of weakness. Certainly it is not. Or some people may go the other extreme and say things like, after all, you did your best and that's it. You should just learn to be philosophical and leave things. So these are some of the insensitive things that one can certainly avoid. If you have nothing to say, just hold the other person's hand, look into the eyes, and just be there as a kind of a support. After some time, you will find that the person may or may not open up to you. If he or she does, well and good, you can be there as a pillar of support. Otherwise, you can look around and see what you can do to help that person. Is it that you can cook a meal, you can clean the house, you can take care of the pet, you can take care of the other children, you can send the others, going on their business of daily life, because life doesn't come to a halt with anyone's death. Others have to sadly enough, carry on with the business of living as normally as possible. So if it is possible, you can take care of those chores so that it relieves this person who is in grief over losing the daughter to come to terms in his or her own way. And time, yes, is the best healer. You should give some time for this person to grieve. It is not necessary for them to not to cry or to immediately divert the mind onto something else, because the grieving has to be completed, and then only one can move on to the next phase, that is of reconstructing one's life without the person in that scenario. The person may be excessively irritable, bitter, angry, sad, refuse to eat, refuse to sleep. Be sympathetic. Don't force food or sleep down this person when he's not ready. Be there for that person. And be kind enough to refrain from making inadvertent hurtful statements. So what you can do which would be helpful, apart from taking care of the day-to-day chores in the person's life, is to also, after a period of time, gently talk about that person, talk about the event, so that any unfinished business in the person's mind can be set to rest. For example, if it's a sudden bereavement, such as an accident or a sudden illness or anything else, the person is always puzzled as to how this happened, whether one could have prevented it. There's a lot of guilt associated with being unable to prevent this misfortune. So one can go over this event and see to it that all these unnecessary guilt and feelings can be addressed in a most helpful and sympathetic way. However, one needs to see the timing, whether the person is right for this kind of conversation or this kind of a step to be taken. And lastly, help the person to reconstruct his or her own life. Look forward, because there are a lot of other things in life one needs to be aware of and to look forward to. And this should be an unfortunate incident that has happened and that will make you stronger as and more probably more compassionate as one lives on in life.